And just like that, everybody, we're back with more CSGO news. I hope you're all doing well. Let's break into it. After weeks of nothing, and I guess you could say overall after months of nothing, but especially after posting this, Ents saying they're going to come forward about the Alexi B transition away from Ents sometime soon, they have now done so. I will link this short video down below. I'll break it down very shortly for all of you guys. They say things that we already knew, and they don't say the things that we wanted to know. But either way, they did come forward. Again, that video will be linked down below for all of you guys. As we all clearly know, Alexi B now on the OG roster, now filling his place will be Sunny back on the Ents roster, and certainly a debatable move. I would say one of the most debatable CSGO roster moves we saw throughout the entire year. The backlash has been insane. That backlash continued on this video, as you guys can see as well. The Finnish community, the CS community, a lot of people out there not very happy. As to go on to tell you guys what they did really say, it wasn't all too unexpected. A lot of us wanted to think about and kind of elaborate on exactly why they made the move. When it came down to roles, why you kick an IGL for, you know, a lineup that could have had, I would say, one other, two other pieces that certainly could have been replaced by Sunny and maybe equaled an improvement, but you replace your IGL with Sunny, and obviously one of the best IGLs that roster might ever see, a young Alexi B goes somewhere else. We didn't need to know the contract situation because many people already speculated what we already kind of thought was happening. They re-extend the entire team contracts shortly before letting Alexi B go. Many people thought that was because it would increase his buyout, the money they got for him, and well, that seems to be what they almost pretty much are saying. As right after their Katowice run, they go on to clarify they extended everyone's contracts. They offered everyone the same extension period on the same day. Obviously, negotiations were underway. While these negotiations were also underway, the opportunity approached themselves as the possibility of signing Sunny to their roster. At this first time, they thought, you know, when it comes to financial feasibility, the possibility of making that giant move, they just can't do it. They go through with the contract extensions, and then as we all know, shortly afterwards, the opportunity represents itself of acquiring Sunny, and after extending their contracts, they think this actually could be possible. So I think it's a long workaround to saying that yes, they re-extend those contracts for a guy like Alexi B. Obviously now financially they can draw in more for him, and thus they can spend more to get the opportunity they wanted with Sunny. And I'm not blaming them. This is business, as they also do say in the video. But when it comes to actually why this decision was made, was it team-based? Was it Alexi-based? Why was it made in the first place when you had a very, very solid, as they even say, core roster? Why was this made? Those details were not given. So overall, why did Ents make the move? Because they had the money to do so after getting rid of Alexi, after extending his contract like they extended everyone else's. I'm not blaming the team. I just wish after all this hype up, all this time, there was more given in terms of context as to why the move itself was made. But that was not given. And now, as we all know, Ents has Sunny, and they are facing probably more backlash than they have faced, I would say, ever in the organization's history. And with that, Alexi now goes to OG. Speaking of the OG roster, one of the speculative players who actually fell off that speculation because of a potential connected VAC-ban account, that's going to be Yampi. We're speaking of him next because he's now been benched from his current roster. That being SJ Gaming. If you guys remember, you might, if you're especially if you're a hardcore fan out there, SJ Gaming was formerly Super Jimmy. And it's very, very weird. So far, they've posted a video. I will show you guys that video as well. Pretty sentimental as to why he's been benched on this roster. Will continue, apparently, to do things for the organization, but not on their starting roster. And I really, really hope this is not due to the fact of his connected VAC-ban account, because SJ Gaming, I do not think, is making any deep major runs anytime soon. And if that's the reason why they made this choice, that would be pretty weird. Now, they make it seem like it was actually Yampi's choice to possibly bench himself, take a break, and really think about his future, and that's why he'll remain inside the organization, just not be playing CSGO for the SJ roster. There's many other rumors out there we'll discuss in a second.
Morjens. Meillä on aika isoja uutisia teille nyt tähän kohtaan. Elias Jampi Olkkonen siirtyy pelaavasta rosterista penkille ja tavallaan muihin tehtäviin organisaatiossa. Eka kertaa, kun mä Jampia itse asiassa olin yhteyksessä, oli sellainen työharjoittelu, mä soitin sille, että haluatko tulla pelaamaan meille. Se taisi olla vuonna 2018 aika alkupuolta, ja siitä asti saanut työskennellä hänen kanssaan. Ja se on ollut iloa kaikin puolin, ja totta kai me halutaan jatkaa kenenkäistä työskentelyä, mutta tämä hetkinen tilanne vaatii sen, että me halutaan antaa Jampille pikkuinen hengen hengitystauko ja katsoa tilannetta ja ottaa rauhassa ja keskittyä myös muihin tehtäviin, mitä me pystytään organisaatio tarjoamaan.
And so with that, they make it seem it actually was Yampi's choice. Now, the two current rumors, I cannot confirm these. It's only talk of the town out there, but it's pretty obvious talk, one of which is they removed him from the starting roster, like I said before, because of his VacBan-connected account. I think that's pretty far-fetched for a roster like SJ to think they'd be making any major runs anytime soon when they've not even gotten anywhere close, I would say, to the major qualifier. Not even close to that. But of course, if that's their goal, and they can't do that with a guy like Yampi if he's not allowed to even participate, then that would seemingly make sense. Other rumors out there, again, that cannot be confirmed, is the speculation of him being benched from the roster because maybe he actually is being signed to a different team. We'll see what happens. All these are rumors right now. Breaking other news out there as of the last 24 hours. That's going to be Simple having his worst career performance on an individual map ever in his entire CSGO career, rating of just 0.3 against Vitality at Epicenter as well. Their run does continue. I love the fact that he has one individual bad map, a terrible map of a 0.3 rating, and it's news because it's so shocking to see. Although, as a Na'Vi fan, it can't be very reassuring when the best player in the world, the best player lineup will ever see, is all of a sudden having career lows as results. That's not very reassuring as to why he's having those. He still ended the series as a middleman for the roster, so I wouldn't be too worried about this. Hopefully not too much on Simple's mind, but it was his worst ever map in his entire professional CSGO career. So hopefully they can pull it back together for the rest of Epicenter this weekend. It's just a wild time, guys. You know, I always love the open honesty. I wish across all of these stories we just had a bit more honesty. Wishing the best of luck for a guy like Yampi we've covered several times here, and especially if this does mean he can't even compete on a lower tier roster. I think it's fair to say like SJ with this connected VacBan account, where can he go? Well, only one part that worried about me as well. In that video, they said he needed to take a break to think about his future. Is this guy actually considering retiring because of all of this, which would have to break your heart? He was so young when all that happened. Alongside that as well, I wish that an organization like Ents could just be open and honest. You know, we see the dislikes around them as well. Just flat out say it. So-and-so wanted to kick him, or the team wanted to kick him, and we'll move past that. I think when it comes to the details, I wish we always knew more, but again, maybe there's their reason as well. There could be equal backlash for their reasoning as to why they removed him. Best of luck to all of these teams going forward. We will see where Yampi goes. I hope the best for this guy in the future and hope a new team is in store. Best of luck to OG as well, you know, a team he could have possibly been joining. And Ents, we'll see if they can bounce back alongside a team like Na'Vi. When your best player is struggling, certainly the team will struggle as well. Until next time, I hope you guys all enjoy breaking down CSGO esports gaming news here every single day, all day long. Hopefully be back here tomorrow with more CSGO news for all of you guys. Until then, drink your coffee, all right? Ta-ta.